Partnerships are vital to our global outreach, enabling us to take the love and hope of Jesus Christ to those who need it most. Our Boots on the Ground partnership program physically ministers to those in desperate situations all over the world. The Israel partnership furthers Kim's legacy of outreach to Israel and Jewish people worldwide. We invite you to become a partner today. Join us today and be part of a community that inspires hope, brings restoration to life, and often healing from the past. Together, we can make a difference, and we thank you for your ongoing support.
Shabbat Shalom and welcome to Israel Update. Dubi is joining me in transit. He's in London at the moment on his way back to Israel. So Dubs, thank you so much for being with me and joining me from your hotel room.
Thank you. I'm actually at the lobby of the hotel because of the internet. And I'm so sorry that thing doesn't look so well.
It doesn't matter.
The good sound, but I hope it's going to work.
It doesn't matter. You're in transit. You're on the way home. But for everybody out there, obviously, you know, Israel's still very much on our mind. And something that's really been unbelievable to me is that there have been crazy protests. I say protests, it's terrorism. It's terrorism light, should I say, outside the Nova exhibition in New York City and again here in LA at the UCLA campus. Crazy protests happening, protests with people freaking out at Jewish students. A rabbi got attacked. The fact that this is going on in college campuses and even in New York City is just absolutely beyond me. The fact that we're watching this happen, I mean, dudes, the climate of everything is just insane.
Yeah, I just came from New York. This was my flight where we're traveling through London because, you know, they don't have the direct flights now. Mm-hmm. And New York, the atmosphere, the spirit, I've spoken to a lot of Jewish people and they're really, really worried. They're afraid. I mean, New York, let me tell you, New York City is the place where there's most Jewish population in the world. I mean, more than Jerusalem, more Jews live in New York than in Jerusalem, actually. And these people are really worried. They're really worried. Their kids are afraid to go to colleges. You know, people don't put yarmulkes on. People took their mezuzahs out of the front of their homes. They put them inside right now. And they've been marked. They've been targeted by those protesters, you call them. These are not regular protesters. These are terrorists, like you said.
It's terrorists. And this is the thing, when you look at that, the fact that Jews in New York are afraid to be identified, the fact that Jews in New York are taking down their mezuzahs, they're not wearing the yarmulkes, the fact that they're going through what they're going through, this is the same climate as pre-World War II, where people started being afraid to identify as Jewish because of the repercussions. The same thing is happening. We saw footage of people being attacked on the subway in New York with these groups of terrorists wandering around, shouting out, asking who's a Jew. And, you know, this has been happening. And yet again, we're seeing terrorists really taking over and starting to sort of dominate the atmosphere in these major cities in the United States, which is supposed to be a free country, and it's supposed to be a place where Jews and Christians alike feel safe, and instead the opposite is starting to happen. And that's really, really disturbing.
You're 100% right. And, you know, I would like to apologize about all the background noises and everything, but, you know, this is like, as we do it on the ground, a little bit rough. You know, that's what we used to do when we were to travel with him. This was, you know, relatively rough. But let me tell you one thing. I mean, as we speak right now, I mean, I was just reading the news back from home, and over 200 rockets were launched, and the entire north part of Israel is burning. It's literally burning right now. I mean, I'm telling you, there's like fire brigades and people trying to fight the fire. Over 4,000 acres of forest that has been planted throughout all these years been totally burnt. People are literally running away. The celebrations today, this is Pentecost. This is Shavuot.
Shavuot.
It's the holy day of weeks, the Shavuot, where it's the most, unbelievable time that God puts aside for the people to come and visit him and come and see him in the Temple Mount. And all of these situation is just horrible. I mean, people are literally praying for miracles, like biblical prayer miracles, because you never know what's going to happen. You never know.
This is the thing, Jeeves. I was looking, obviously, I have the alerts that go off on my phone, and the fact that there were launches against Tiberias, in Galilee. You're seeing footage from the Sea of Galilee, watching rockets being launched and fires burning. I mean, it's insane when you look at this and see that the whole north is being targeted. Lebanon is obviously, you know, because of Hezbollah, there's just these attacks that are being, it's simultaneous, and it's, again, it's coming from Gaza, it's coming from Lebanon, and we know this. We know that it's planned. We know that they're united. We know that these terrorist organizations, it's the same face, it's just a different location, it's just a different geography, but it's all the same spirit.
And Christy, the crazy thing is that we can find a solution to that. We have to take off our gloves and, you know, and just wait for the wait, and then the people will put pressure over the Hezbollah and the others. But Israel tries to be like more religious than the Pope, and trying to be like more surgical than possible. And that's the biggest story right here. That's the story. And today, unfortunately, we had an Israeli reservist soldier who committed suicide. He literally killed himself because he said that this is impossible. They want to recruit him to a military that cannot really fight. They are twisting, you know, the arms. They have to fight with the hands tied around their backs.
Yes.
And he says, why do you want to take me to a situation like that where we cannot really fight the way we should fight? I mean, listen, America lost over 4,000 people on Pearl Harbor, which was awful. Yes. But they dropped two huge bombs on Japan, and 400,000 people were killed. And then they want us be like, you know, measuring our acts and doing like proportionate retaliation, all these things that they are demanding from Israel. I mean, actually, Biden and Blinken, they spoke about the deal that Netanyahu was putting on, literally sending to the Hamas the opportunity. And the Hamas are saying right now that, you know, Israel is in a dire situation. We are under pressure. The world is coming against us because so-called uninvolved people were killed. What do you mean uninvolved? These last hostages that they were able to release now in Gaza, they were captured in the house of a doctor and a journalist that works for Al Jazeera. These are civilians, so-called, and they were holding hostages in their homes for a month. Can you imagine this? And then they say, all these people are uninvolved. You know, it's, you have to be more surgical. It's crazy.
It is crazy. And that's the thing. And like, as you can see, Dubs is coming to us from a hotel lobby in London.
There's a Chinese airline now that the workers just came into the hotel to check in.
There's a little bit of chaos there in the background. But Dubs, thank you for joining me. I know this has been a short show. And everybody, next week, you're going to hear from Dubi from the ground, from Israel again. So make sure you tune in. Remember, pray for the peace of Jerusalem. Pray for Dubi. Pray for his family. Pray for his protection.
I just want to say that I finished my journey in the U.S. and I was there for almost a month and a half. And I visited multiple Christian organizations. And I can tell you one thing that people told me in every place I went. They say, Dubi, we never knew. We don't hear the news. The media channels are just, you know, bringing us the news that they want to bring us. But I can tell you today, there was a breakthrough, which was unbelievable. One of the things that we might even been praying for, you know, CNN had never been siding with Israel, never been really giving the... But they did say today... on an article today or yesterday, they did say on an article that we have detected, the CNN, they have detected through their sources that Sinwar, the head of Hamas in Gaza, is saying that we won the war because look what happens with Israel. Israel is in a tough situation. America is putting pressure over Israel. And they even said that Israel was very honest and they gave them an offer that they shouldn't have refused. But they're refusing because they expect the international community to go down and get back at Israel and say that we're doing the bad things. So you can imagine this situation, even the CNN is testifying.
Yes, that's when you know.
On our side, they're even saying that Israel was giving a very honest offer and Hezbollah is refusing because the world and the international groups of people. Even the UN today were saying, you know, one of the UN committees were saying that Israel is the aggressor and Israel is doing all these problems. That's the situation that is happening now. Nobody's seeing the truth.
Yes, it's true. And so everybody out there, keep praying, keep standing, keep supporting. Dubi's going to be back on the ground soon. Pray for his protection. Pray for the peace of Jerusalem. And next week we'll be back with a brand new episode, as always, on IsraelUpdate.org. So God bless you. Shabbat shalom. And we'll see you soon.
Thank you so much, everybody. And I'm so sorry about this being a very rough
road. Totally fine.
I think that sometimes you like it.
Yes, I agree. So catch us next week. Dubi will be in Israel.
Thank you, Christy. Bye-bye.
On Real Life, Real Faith, we're going to be discussing giving our children or our loved ones to God. There are people that are sick. There are people that are anxious. There are people that are living under tremendous weight right now because you're worried about your kids. Well, get on over here, and we're going to have a great time discussing this together.
To celebrate the new year, we're having the biggest sale ever on overstock clearance and brand new products. For example, save 60% on our Goose Down Comforters, the best comforters ever. They go perfectly with our MyPillow bed sheets and duvet covers. Save 25% on our brand new kitchen towels. They're made with the same technology as our famous My Towels. Our initial quantities are extremely low, so get them now before they go. Our seasonal flannel sheets are finally in. You save up to 50% and they sell out fast every year, so order now. They're truly the best flannel sheets you'll ever sleep on. Or save up to 80% on all our clearance items. And this is where it gets even better. For a limited time, your entire order ships absolutely free. So go to MyPillow.com or call the number on your screen. Use that promo code to get deep discounts on all MyPillow products. And for a limited time, your order ships absolutely free.
We here at the House of Destiny are partnering with you to let our viewers, of course, know about your company. It's Beverly Hills Precious Metal.
Andrew, explain how that works.
So I'll walk you through it right now. So if you go to bh-pm.com, right there on the homepage, you'll see a form that you could fill out. And that form is very important in letting us know how we can help you. So you just put in your first name, last name, email address, phone number. There's a section that says, how did you hear about us? And in there, put Kim Clement. And then there's a portion where you could write a couple of notes down on the bottom, usually within about 24 to 48 hours, we'll contact you by phone call, and then we'll go over everything with you. This isn't a high pressure deal. We always recommend that if you feel uncomfortable, take a step back, pray about it. You will gain the answers that you need by doing that, and come back to us when you're comfortable.